Well, thank you, everybody. Thank you for being here. Again, my name is Isabella Zizi. I am Northern Cheyenne, Arikara, and Muscogee Creek. And I am a part of the I Don't Know More SFA group located here in the East Bay. What I'd first like to do is recognize the Ohlone people. The Ohlone people are the ones who this land belongs to. And so I just want to pray right now, thank you to the ancestors. Thank you for letting us be here today and letting us be here on this land, and really just raise awareness about protecting the land, protecting the Mother Earth, and protecting the people, because everything, our life is very important, not only our life, but the plants, the animals, the water, and the air, everything is important. And also, I just wanted to talk a little about the I Don't Know More SFA group. We coordinate refinery healing walks, and I have just a few little flyers that I could pass out to you guys. But the refinery healing walks raise awareness in the East Bay from Pittsburgh all the way down to Richmond, California. And there's about 5 oil refineries there. And this is a big matter to me and also to all of us, because the youth need to grow stronger to have a bigger voice. And that's kind of why I'm here today, too, to let you guys know that, you know, this matter is really important to me. And I can't really describe, like, what it's like to have to live at a time like this. And I really hope that this TPP does not get passed, because not only my future is at risk, but also our grandchildren and their grandchildren, also the future kids that aren't even born yet. They would have to deal with tons of health issues, and also probably have to do the same thing that we're doing. So we're going against this TPP, which is the Trans-Pacific Partnership, for those who don't know. Sorry, I keep saying Yes, it's just really important to me, and we just need to raise awareness and really need to stick together and really need to reach out to the youth, because the youth will have a stronger voice later on in the future. And I really appreciate all of you guys being here and really standing your ground against the TPP, and standing outside of the Senate's office, of course, and raising awareness, letting her know that this needs to end. We don't need to be digging up any of the crude oil anymore. We don't need to be letting the toxins flow through the air, because a lot of us don't know what we're inhaling. And so I think I'm just going to end it right there. Thank you all again, and have a wonderful day.
Thank you so much, Isabella. Wonderful to hear from you. And by the way, I'm Phoebe Sorgan, and I've been working on democracy issues for over a decade. And so ending corporate personhood is important, and the TPP would undermine that, even if we got that done, or I shall say, even when we get that done. So we got to stop the TPP in the meantime. And next up is Myra Sutton of the Electronic Frontier Foundation. She is the global policy analyst for the EFF. Myra, oh, here we go.
Hi, thanks for coming out today. So, as Phoebe introduced, I am Myra from the Electronic Frontier Foundation. We are a digital rights organization that's been around for over 25 years now, and we are a public interest litigation organization as well as an advocacy organization fighting for people's rights to use and speak and have their privacy on the internet and on their digital devices. So we are suing the NSA, for instance, for a long time before it was cool, before the Snowden leaks, and Snowden definitely gave us more more evidence of their mass surveillance programs. We also fight for people to use and remix content, copyrighted content. I'm going to talk more about that and how that TPP has implications for our rights to remix a little bit more. But for those of you who are maybe just passing through and don't know what the Trans-Pacific Partnership is. It's the TPP. The TPP is a trade agreement between 12 countries across the Pacific, and it has been negotiated for over 5 years. And it finally became public, the text became public, after more than 5 years of secret negotiations. And the text was secret for all 5 years and more of those negotiations. We only knew what was in this massive agreement, 30 chapters of provisions, from leaks. We had a few leaks over the course of those 5 years. And all we knew about the agreement were little things, and they were usually outdated as well. So when we had a leak, it was usually, you know, a few months old already, and so we didn't actually even know what we were talking about when we could criticize the agreement, because every little wording makes a difference. And so when you hear what the USTR says about this agreement, and, you know, now we have a text to point to, but when the trade agreement has over thousands and thousands of pages, every word counts. When the USTR says, oh, this trade agreement is pro-internet, when this trade agreement protects the environment or protects patients, we knew to be skeptical because of the process itself. These committees called trade advisor committees are made up of corporate advisors that have been influencing the text from the very beginning, whereas public interest groups like the EFF, like Food and Water Watch, like Sierra Club and Public Citizen were completely excluded from the process. I was at many of these negotiations, and we had maybe 5 minutes to tell these negotiators what was actually problematic about these deals, whereas corporate representatives were able to see the text live and comment on the text as it was being drafted. So the first problem, of course, is this process, that it was completely secret from the beginning, that it was captured by corporations, which leads to the second problem, which is the actual provisions in this agreement. And we have many speakers today talking about the other aspects of this agreement, but the EFF has been concerned about the TPP for its implications for what you can do on the internet and what you can do on your digital devices. And I'll go through a few of those. So the first are provisions that would make it a crime for you to tinker with your device, to modify your device, or repair it, or recycle it. And that has to do with these rules called bans on circumventing the digital locks on the software on your devices. And when we talk about, you know, you have a phone in our pocket every day, our cars come with software, our e-books, our books essentially are our software, all of these things are increasingly coming with software. And when it's a crime to tinker with these devices, it's a crime to do the things we want to do with the things that we rightfully own. And so really, it's becoming more like we're renting these things rather than actually owning these things. And so when it's a crime to tinker with devices, that means farmers who have farming equipment aren't able to repair their own devices. That means libraries that get e-books aren't able to rent and lend these books to whoever patron comes to their desk. That means people with visual disabilities and other sorts of disabilities aren't able to translate these things to formats that they can actually experience and read. So there's a huge number of things that is dangerous from these provisions that make it a crime to tinker with our devices. The second thing are these rules that is sadly in U.S. law already, and many of these are actually in U.S. law, which makes it much easier for people to take down content off the internet when they say it's a copyright infringement. You'll see that there are things, maybe you have recorded a birthday party that has a copyrighted song, and you suddenly find out that that video that you post on YouTube is gone, or a political advertisement that uses a copyrighted song or happens to have copyrighted images immediately gets taken down, even though it might be fair use, meaning there's a right for you to comment on that content, for you to use that content, but these online platforms are increasingly becoming scared of having the copyright infringement liability, and they're taking down legitimate speech, our speech, off the internet. The third issue is what many of these organizations are also concerned about, and EFF is also very concerned about, is what's called this ISDS system, this investor state dispute settlement system, where courts where companies have the power to use this tribunal system.
Walk over a little bit.
There we go. So this ISDS system is a court system where companies can challenge public interest laws, any democratic law that they say undermines their expected future profits or their investments in a country. This has happened many times already. There are dozens and dozens of cases where this has happened. For instance, in Canada, under the North American Free Trade Agreement, a pharmaceutical company, Eli Lilly, is challenging a court ruling finding a medicine cannot be patented and that it should be a generic medicine. And they're undermining this court ruling in Canada under this ISDS system, saying, well, invalidating our medicine patent on this medicine undermines our expected future profits, so you owe us millions of dollars, state of Canada. This has happened across South America as well regarding oil mining and other kinds of mining where countries trying to prevent themselves from, you know, very extractive industries and extractive practices of resources. But what we're afraid of is that because of this new definition, the TPP, user rights regarding what we can do with copyrighted content, that's culture, that's books, that's songs, that's everything, that we will have less and less rights to do this, and that companies, if we try to create these new rules in Congress, that Hollywood, for instance, Disney or Universal, will try and use this ISDS system to carve away our rights on the Internet. So those are just three issues of many issues that we're concerned about. And as many of you know, the TPP was signed yesterday in a closed meeting again. If you saw the signing yesterday, there was maybe 20 people in the room who witnessed this massive agreement getting signed. And now we wait for Congress to maybe vote on it. We actually can't wait. We have to preempt this legislation from getting introduced. We know that Obama and the White House can introduce this legislation anytime after mid-May when the International Trade Commission comes out with its report. And sadly, they're only doing a review of the economic impacts of this trade agreement. They're not doing an impact about, you know, what it will do to the Internet. They're not going to do an official report about what it will do with our free speech, with our human rights, to our environment, to our access to medicine. They're only doing an economic report. And when you think about what the USTR and the White House continually says about, you know, the TPP is going to create this fraction of a percentage point of GDP growth or this many jobs. What they're saying, what they're not saying, is what it's going to do with your rights, what it's going to do with all of our interests and how we live our daily lives. So what I'd like to end with is to urge you to take action. Please call your representatives. We have a tool at EFF. If you go to EFF.org/no TPP, there's a very easy tool where you can email your Congress members. But if you can, try and organize a meeting with your Congress members when they're home. Try and call them. Call them every day, because this is a huge agreement, and it's going to have huge implications for what we can do in the Internet and what it means for democracy. Thank you.
Thanks so much, Myra Sutton. And there's an 800 number. If you have a cell phone with you now, you could just program this number into your phone right now. It's an 800 number for Capitol Hill, and it's going to go to the House Ways and Means Committee, then to the full House of Representatives, then to the Senate Finance Committee, and then to the full Senate, assuming that it passes in the previous three steps. So the 800 number is 826-3688, and you can just call that number over and over. It'll take you. You can reach any of the members of Congress or senators in D.C. And later, yes, 1-800-826-3688. That's toll free to Capitol Hill. Later, Maven is going to give us the number for Feinstein's San Francisco office. But next up, we have somebody very special, and I'm so glad to have heard his amazing poetry a few weeks ago at the UU Church, where Tim DeChristopher was speaking, remember the bitter 70. There was a film made about him. He's the courageous young man who bid on land he couldn't afford to keep it from oil development, and then spent a couple of years in prison for it, and now he's in Harvard Divinity School. So, you know, there are lots of ways we can resist. And but anyway, at his event, I heard Dee Allen, who's going to now share some spoken word with us that was written, I think, especially for this occasion. Come on up, Dee.
Whoa, feedback. I feel like I'm at a Melvins concert.
There you go.
All right, can any of y'all hear me now?
Yeah.
Cool. Before I go into the little piece that I wrote for this occasion, I want to give a big shout out to all the, those 1,000 protesters that showed up in Central Auckland, New Zealand yesterday.
Yeah.
And surrounded Sky City Convention Center. Especially the native New Zealanders, the Maori people, who came out in force in the Hauoki against the TTP, the TPP, I meant. This one thing that's going to be bad for everybody across the planet, including the 12 signatory countries.
Yep.
I'm not going to add much to the discussion because you got a lot of speakers coming up and one other poet who kicks butt, somebody by the name of Karen Melander. You're going to hear her later on with her own written protest against the TPP. This is a new one that I wrote for Phoebe Ann Sorgan of Move to Amend. For Shahid Buttar of Electronic Frontier Foundation.
Yay.
And Janet Wheel of Code Pink. This one is called Plans.
Yay.
Everybody's got plans to be prosperous and stay prosperous. Everybody's got plans to take more than they'd rather give. Everybody's got plans to own more than anybody should. Everybody's got plans, especially if everybody wears a suit daily. Makes 7 figures yearly and already occupies the 1%. Everybody's got plans to get richer no matter who or what they hurt, and local laws and tariffs in certain countries hurts their plans. Everybody's got plans. Whoa. Can this cord go any longer or anything like that?
Yeah,
everybody's got plans to force a loophole, to force pry a loophole open. Everybody's got plans to meet somewhere distant and secret. Everybody's got plans. Public access and comment are denied from passing through the shut boardroom door. Arguments between companies, trade ministers over tentative plans to take privacy, neutrality, and freedom away from the electronic frontier, drive the cost of medicines higher, drive our wages lower, outsource work to union-crushing, child-enslaving, sea-polluting nations, send contaminated, unlabeled fish to our shores and other shores, sue governments in foreign courts over estimated money they might have made. Give strong copyright protections to corporate creations. Self-produced labors of love and culture be damned. Everybody's got definite plans to widen the class divide. No more middle ground. Workers pay cut. Everybody's got surefire plans, similar to plans they've tried before. WTO, NAFTA, FTAA, CAFTA, G7, G8, G20. Sound familiar?
Yeah.
They do to me. I haven't seen a sad day in California when the suits over there sign on to fast-track the rewriting of life, a move most expected from Georgia and Texas. Everybody's got ironclad plans they could benefit from. What plans? They concern 12 industrial nations in the Pacific Rim. America takes the lead. Six more won in. America's aggressive will prods the rest. 21st century diplomatic piracy by corporate execs. Made for us since they ignore us, rewriting the rules of life. Their international partnership spells out our future strife. Hundreds rich, billions broke. Yeah, those plans. That was a new poem called Plans. I'm D. Allen. You're the crowd. Thanks for listening. Stop the TPP.
Thank you so much, D. And I was just handed the phone number for Feinstein's San Francisco office, so people could be calling there right now. And I talked with her aide recently. We have an appointment on Monday afternoon. A delegation is going to meet with her aide. She's in D.C. But her aide said that absolutely what's happening here now outside will inform her decision. Her local phone number office is 415-393-0707. So that's a good one also to program into your cell phones and keep calling her over and over. 415-393-0707. Because she's supposed to be representing we the people, but she's representing the 1% a lot of the time. Okay, next up, we have Ella Teven from Food and Water Watch. Thank you, Ella.
Good afternoon, everybody. How are we feeling? It sounds like you're a little scared of the TPP. Is that true?
Yeah, me too. I am outraged. My name's Ella Teven, and I work with a group called Food and Water Watch. We champion healthy food and clean water for everybody, not just the 1%, and we work to fix our broken democracy. And as you've heard today, I'm sorry to say, the Trans-Pacific Partnership threatens all those vital things that we fight so hard to protect: our food, our water, our democracy, and so much more. So that's why we're here today, to call on Senator Feinstein to oppose the TPP.
Yeah.
Woo! So, what do we know about the TPP? We've heard a little bit from the previous speakers. We know that it's the biggest trade deal in history. It's a deal with 11 other countries to hand a huge amount of power to some of the world's most powerful already special interests. So, what does that mean? Multinational corporations had a seat at the table, as we heard, during the TPP negotiations to ensure the final deal would boost their bottom line. So if it passes, it's going to cost us jobs, it's going to threaten our food safety, and it can even increase fracking in communities in the States and here in California, because these corporations can challenge policies that communities have passed banning fracking in their communities. The TPP makes it easier for corporations to challenge and win in these kinds of trade disputes than any other agreement to date. So what does that look like? It looks like challenges to country of origin labeling for meat, which means people can't be informed about what foods they're putting in their bodies. It looks like a second chance for everyone's least favorite pipeline, Keystone XL, whose landmark defeat was a huge victory for us in the environmental community. And Keystone's defeat is currently being challenged under a similar corporate trade suit under NAFTA. And you've probably heard that the TPP is NAFTA on steroids. So now you know a little bit about what we're up against. So what else do we know? We know, as we've heard, that the U.S. just signed the agreement in New Zealand. However, that does not mean it's a done deal. I'm going to say that again. That does not mean the TPP is a done deal. The president still needs to submit the deal to Congress, along with the legislation that would make all of the federal laws and regulations go into compliance with this corporate-friendly deal. So once Obama introduces it, Congress has 90 days to vote, and because Fast Track passed last year, Congress can only give the TPP the up or down vote. So that means they can't take issue with particular provisions. They either have to vote yes or no. So that means Senator Feinstein and our other members of Congress still have the opportunity to say no. And that's why we're here today, to call on Senator Feinstein to oppose the TPP, to oppose secret trade deals for our democracy and for Californians. And that's why we're here today, so we're going to yell, and we're going to hope that she can hear us at our window right now, and she and her staff. So on the count of three, we're going to yell no on TPP. Are you ready? One, two, three.
No!
Do you think she heard us? I think we should.
more time. One, two, three.
No on TPP.
Senator Feinstein, stand with us. Stand up against the TPP. Thank you.
Thank you, Ella of Food and Water Watch. So important to keep our food and water safe. It's just horrendous what's happening now. So, you know, the Pacific Island nations will be particularly harmed by TPP. So we have two Pacific Islander representatives who are up next, if they're here yet. Kapiolani Lee and her sister Loa Niumeitolu. If you're here, please come forward. If not, maybe later. Okay. I guess they're not here yet. So, and I just have to honor all of you who did come out and show up, because it's a little scary with what's happening with the brutality bowl and the overreaction of the police presence there and so forth. And so I know some people were concerned about that, understandably, but I think we're going to be fine, and we're going to stick up for each other no matter what happens. But I don't think we're not going to have any trouble. So next up, we're going to have singer banjo player Doug Chambers. I love Doug. Doug is a member of the congregation that I'm a member of, too, the Berkeley Fellowship of Unitarian Universalists, and he's a stalwart there. And I'm very glad that Doug is going to be sharing his music with us. Now, we need another human mic stand. One of us can... Okay, good. So
many bad things about this. Check. So I was looking through protest songs. I thought maybe I'd write a song, and well, it came down to something really simple. So maybe we could all sing.
Verse that I don't really
totally remember. But I learned it recently, and I think it's really good. That's why I went out, and I saw a sign, and the sign said, no trespassing, but on the other side, it didn't say nothing. This land was made for you and me. This land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream water, this land was made for you and me. One more time, this land is your land. This land is my land. From California to the New York Island, from the Redwood Forest to the Gulf Stream waters, this land was made for you and me. Thank you.
The TPP may ban public banking, and it certainly will be challenged if the TPP passes. Public banks will be challenged by the Wall Street banks. The same way that I think you've heard that the that TransCanada has challenged the Obama administration for banning the Keystone Pipeline. The basis of the challenge is that it deprives them of future profits, future imaginary profits. So I would expect that the Wall Street banks would try to ban any public banks. At the moment, the only public bank in the country is the Bank of North Dakota, which has been around for 100 years, is staggeringly successful. It returns a 25% return to the general fund of North Dakota. And North Dakota, because of the bank, not because of its oil, has the lowest foreclosure rate in the country, the lowest unemployment rate, the lowest community bank failure rate, the lowest credit card default rate. It's a prosperous state because of the bank. So we have just begun, well, two pieces of news. The city of Santa Fe has just released a report saying that a public bank of Santa Fe is both feasible and desirable. Yes. And the city of Philadelphia has just agreed to hold hearings in its city council about the possibility of a public bank. So, how much farther behind Santa Fe and Philadelphia can we be? It's time for a public bank of Oakland. Yes. That will help us fight the TPP. But we have to fight the TPP to be able to keep the possibility of public banks alive. Thank you.
Thank you, Susan, and thank you for coming and speaking and so much for all of your work over the years. Next, we have Gigi Winter, and I'm going to let we are the many, you are the few.
representing the few and not the many. Nancy Pelosi is another one that we need to lobby, the minority leader. She did not help us all in getting the Fast Track defeated, and so we need to keep working on her. And at that toll-free 800 number, you can also reach Pelosi's office and pressure her, especially San Franciscans, since she's from San Francisco. All right. Who's up next?
I have total confidence that we're going to do it. I'm from Label GMOs Bay Area, and I know most of us are very concerned about what's in our food. We got a good start on our labeling GMOs movement in the country. Vermont's about to go online this summer, and we've got 6 or 7 states in play. We're going to do it. It's just taking a while. But if this law passes, we're going to have a hard time because companies like Monsanto are going to go to the tribunal, which you've heard about, and they're going to say, this will possibly affect future profits, labeling GMOs. So it's very likely that if it passes, we're not going to have that privilege anymore of being able to know what's in our food. And that's a terrible thing. So we've got to defeat it. And we've got, there's only one way to do it. Lobbying our U.S. reps and our U.S. senators. That's it. There's really no other way. So Phoebe just talked about Pelosi. She hasn't taken a stand. Barbara Boxer voted the right way on Fast Track. She voted against it. But she hasn't declared on the TPP. Diane Feinstein has not declared on the TPP. But she says that she's against the DARK Act, which goes along with that you're against the TPP, if you're against the DARK Act, which would eliminate all labeling in the United States. So if she wants to be consistent, she's going to have to be against the TPP. We know that Hillary is leaning strongly against it. I don't know if I totally trust her, but she says she's against it. We know that a lot of the Republicans, even Trump, say they're against it. We don't know if we believe that, but that's what they're saying. So I think we have a good chance.
Bernie Sanders,
he's always going to be on our side, of course. Is just get used to calling every day. Let's put the phone number in our phone. Let's do it one more time. Get out your phone, those who haven't done it. We're going to put the phone number in the phone, or you're going to put it next to your landline on a piece of paper. It takes 30 seconds to do this every day. It's not hard. Okay, here's Diane's number. Here's the local number, which was already given out. I'm going to give it out again in case you missed it. You could write it on your hand. You could put it in your phone. 415-393-0707. In the next hour, maybe we could each call. If we all call at the same time, it'll get jammed, but that's okay. Keep trying so that everyone here will give a call and try and do it every day. There's a free capital switchboard, which a lot of you probably know by heart, 202-224-3121. It's not free, but if you're a credo member,
she's out here stopping on the